mental fortitude and focus to not make a mistake here.
He essentially just needs to take care of business. It's a dead heat after two stones.
Leachy's focus looks on point as he easily grabs that stone and puts it on the platform.
440-pound stone is up. Final stone for the title, 460 pounds, the American Martins Leitzis. And with that, he is the 2019 World's Strongest Man.
Incredible. Now he's encouraging his rival, Kieliszkowski, in the most defining moment of Leitzis' career.
Kieliszkowski disappointed. He will settle for second place. And there's half-Thor Julius Bjornsson, last year's champ. His good friend and training partner, Leitzis, this year's champ.
Sportsmanship at its finest.
Well, there is an outside chance, of course, that Marius could retain his title, but it really is a long shot. Verastiuk off to the quickest start, being chased down by Savickas. But it's all about Vasil Verastiuk, whoever wins this event between the two of them, providing they don't finish in fourth place or lower, is going to become the new world's strongest man. And Marius, I think, knows his title has gone. Vasil Verastiuk is on the final stone and he's got it. We have a new world's strongest man, and the Ukraine have their very first world's strongest man. Superb.
And this is simply the biggest moment in the career of Žydrūnas Savickas. After being runner-up on three occasions, the Lithuanian is closing in on that elusive title. Žydrūnas has a two-point advantage over that man, Mariusz Pudzianowski. That means the five-time champ will need to beat Savickas by at least three places in the Atlas Stones to overcome the deficit.
Žydrūnas has won it all in this sport, except this title. He'll never have a better chance. A little trouble on that first stone by Savickas.
On to the second stone, 245 pounds, and Mariusz has a problem. Now they're dead even on the third stone. And Savickas now surging ahead. One more stone for Savickas, and the title is his.
What a display of power.
He's got it. Žydrūnas Savickas has dethroned the king.
We know Mariusz is hurting, but even he has to admit Žydrūnas is the better man.
However, this is a similar event to the dramatic finale in Sun City last year, where this man just beat Austrian Manfred Herbel to take the title. So he certainly knows the technique and he's got the strength, but how far and how fast can he go? That's number four, and this is looking good. Number five with a bit of a struggle. The crowd going absolutely crazy for Magnus, especially Auster, who can be heard above all the rest. Now number seven, this one weighs 120 kilos, and this is where Anton finished his challenge. The last one coming up, all 20 stones of it, 280 pounds. Can he do it? Can he become the first man to get the eight stones? He does. Fantastic, and he might well celebrate. I think Venneberg knows his chance is gone.
Travis Ortmeier of Texas continues to gut it out in this final. His ankle injury has limited him, but he remains in fourth place in the overall standings. You can't totally discount Mikhail Kokhlaev. The Russian would need a tremendous amount of good fortune to win the title. Realistically, he'll end up having a respectable third place finish in his rookie campaign.
Okay, guys, white line. Ready?
First stone, 245 pounds, no problem for either man.
That first platform is really tall.
265, the second stone, again, no problems.
As the stones get heavier, the platforms get just a little bit lower.
310 complete, now we're onto the 360 pound stone, and look at Kokhlaev, already onto the final stone, that's 405 pounds.
Ortmeier is just having a really tough time with that ankle.
And Kokhlaev gets it done. 39.83 seconds, all five stones. Meanwhile, Travis Ortmeier He may have gone as far as he can. And it's the Russian Mikhail Kuklyev, currently in second place in the Atlas Stones. A gutty performance by the American Travis Ortmeier.
World's strongest man, and this is another.
Get ready, on the whistle.
Here we go. It's all come down to this for the places and for the championship as well. Two good runners, these guys. 95 kilograms on top of the highest part of that wall. Phil Pfister, look at the strength. And Martin Muir is absolutely flying here. Number two, the third one, 130 kilos. That weighs as much as he does. And he's made it look like a featherweight. Phil Pfister as well, although the German is a little quicker over the ground. And in fact, Pfister gets that one up even quicker. 135 kilos. That is over 20 stones. Now, can he do number five? This is always the biggest test for any strongman, this massive stone of 165 kilos. Oh, Pfister's dropped it. He almost put it on his foot, and Muir is just centimeters away. He's done it. The Lochte man has done it. That is a phenomenal piece of strength. There go the splits as well. What a competitor. Pfister still going. He's not run out of time, but I think he's run out of strength and energy. It is the end for both of them, and Muir finished with a flourish.